Hey there, and welcome to Play Noggin. I'm Julian, your brain's player too. The idea of traveling in space is something we've explored before, and I'm sure it's something we'll explore again. I just love the limitless possibilities of space. One game in particular that has been bouncing around in my head for a long time is Halo. And while there's a lot about Halo I could talk about, for example, are there any creatures on Earth as terrifying as the Flood? Today, I want to talk about Ringworlds. The titular Halos in the series' mythology are ring-shaped installations built to serve as the ultimate failsafe against the Flood by ending all sentient life. The idea being, I guess, that annihilation by the Flood is significantly worse than annihilation by a giant space laser jamboree. These halos are giant rings in space with their own gravity, atmosphere, and ecosystems. Alien megastructures aren't just science fiction. In 2016, scientists observed a star that got dimmer and brighter in an unpredictable pattern. While a lot of explanations were proposed, the one that grabbed the most headlines suggested some sort of alien megastructure called a Dyson sphere was blocking out light as it harvested energy from the star. I know it's unlikely, but we haven't ruled it out yet. My takeaway is structures like halos could exist somewhere out there for real. One of the biggest hurdles to overcome is exactly how we build the dang thing. It's not as simple as putting together a bunch of parts, bungee cording them to a space shuttle, and having an army of robots solder the thing together. Our shuttles today use chemical propulsion, which is great for launching rockets out of the pull of Earth's gravity, but they really can't handle carrying more than 20 or 30 metric tons to low Earth orbit. The International Space Station weighs in at about 500 metric tons, and something the size of a halo would probably be more in the million-plus metric ton range. Our current method of propulsion just isn't going to cut it. We'll need to develop nuclear electric or nuclear thermal propulsion systems to be able to handle the necessary load. Putting it together is a completely different issue. We don't have a big group of mysterious forerunners to do it for us, so it would take an immense amount of physical and robotic labor to get it done. Finding the raw materials to make these things isn't going to be easy either. Sure, we could deplete the Earth of all its natural resources, but we're kind of already doing that. So how much will be left to work with when it comes time to build our first halo? Ideally, we could harvest raw materials from asteroids. The Kuiper Belt outside the orbit of Neptune is filled with asteroids just waiting to be mined. Some people disagree, saying that in reality, the Kuiper Belt is less dense than we think, but if we put the same dedication into stripping it of resources that we do the Earth, I'm sure we'll get it done. Okay, I'm done throwing shade. To build something as big as a halo, we'll not only need a lot of material, but a lot of strong material. Anything of such substantial size is going to be subject to a ton of stress, enough to break apart any normally built structures. Simple molecular bonds might not be enough to hold it together, so we'd be wise to use what is known as the strong nuclear force. It's one of the four fundamental forces in nature, the other three of which are gravity, electromagnetism, and the weak force. The strong force has 137 times the strength of electromagnetism, a million times that of the weak force, and, hang on, let me bust out the old calculator here, a duodecillion times the force of gravity. The power of the strong force keeps protons stuffed together in a nucleus, and normally electromagnetic repulsion would push those protons apart. The strong force is, like we already said, way stronger, so it keeps them stuck together. Now, we're a ways off from harnessing this strong force. We could use the glue that holds protons together, called gluons, to bind our materials together. That might be overkill, since halos are really only about 10,000 kilometers in diameter. Steel might be good enough, but I'm not super willing to take the risk myself. Go big or go home, right? Now, once this thing is built, we need gravity, and not just so your warthog has something to drive on. Gravity will also be responsible for keeping the atmosphere from spilling out into the void of space. We'll need walls to keep that atmosphere in, but no ceiling is necessary. All we have to do is spin it. By spinning the ring, we take advantage of a property of matter called inertia. Inertia keeps still objects from just jumping up and wandering around on their own, and it keeps moving objects moving uniformly in a straight line unless some other force, like friction, changes that. Objects like space marines standing on the outside of a spinning halo would be flung off into space, traveling in a straight line tangential to the ring world. But if they stand on the inside of the ring, like in the game, then the ground pushes against their feet to force them to travel in a curve. The net effect feels like gravity, and we call it centrifugal force. Keep in mind, centrifugal force doesn't actually exist. There's nothing pushing you straight down onto Halo's surface. It only feels that way because our bodies want to fly off in a straight line, but the ground keeps pressing against us. It's a bit like that crazy spinning ride at amusement parks. You get in, the thing starts to spin, and the floor drops out beneath you. You don't fall because the spinning creates enough centrifugal force to keep you pressed against the wall. To achieve the 1G required to mimic Earth's gravity, a halo would need to spin at 7.9 kilometers per second, or nearly 28,500 kilometers per hour. If the Earth spun that fast, you'd get flung off into space, and days would be shorter than an hour and a half. Halos would need to rotate even faster, completing one full rotation in just an hour and 6 minutes. While it'd feel like you had normal gravity, the stars above you would look like they were frantically whizzing around. I hope Master Chief didn't eat a big lunch, or the inside of that helmet is gonna be mighty messy. Hey, thanks for watching. If you like what we do, give us a like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. What would you name your own man-made planet? Drop it in the comments below. Want to talk more about space science? Check out this video on how long it would take to get to the center of our galaxy. And don't forget to keep on playing.